Good morning, children. Let's continue the chapter. Yesterday we stopped where Franz was saying that these words were a thunderclap to me. You remember what were the words of M. Hamel? M. Hamel announced in the class that today this is your last French lesson, and from tomorrow onwards, German will be taught in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. These words were a thunderclap for him. And now he realized why the village elders were sitting in the classroom. And here comes our next question. Why were the elders sitting in the classroom? Write the question. Hope you are ready with the notebook. Why were the village elders sitting in the classroom? Actually, the elders of the village were sitting in the classroom to attend the last French lesson. It was done not only to pay respect to M. Hamel, but to pay respect to their own language. Hope you have written the question. Why were the elders of the village sitting in the classroom? The answer is, it was their way to pay respect to their teacher, M. Hamel, for his 40 years of service, and to pay respect to their own language. Hope you have written it. Continuing. When Franz was thinking about all these things, he heard his name called out, and it was a stern to recite the rules of participles. Franz thought, this is our last French lesson. I will recite each and every rules of participles. But what happened? He could not, on the first word itself, he got everything mixed up. And he stood there holding on to the desk. He was expecting that M. Hamel would be scolding him. But nothing happened. In a very calm and composed manner, M. Hamel said, it's not your mistake, Franz. This is the mistake of the people. That is the great trouble with Alsace. The people, they put off learning till tomorrow. If you pretend to be Frenchman, and now what happens? You can neither speak or nor write your own language. And this is the last day of it. And for this, for the children not learning their lessons properly, M. Hamel, he blamed the parents. M. Hamel blamed the parents that they were not anxious to send their children to school. Instead, they were eager to send their children for work so that they can earn a little more money. And yeah, at this point, M. Hamel, he was blaming even himself. Whenever he wanted a day off to take rest, he used to give the children a holiday. Or sometimes, whenever he wanted to go for fishing, he used to give the children a holiday. Or sometimes he used to send the children for watering his plants. Here comes the next question. Who did M. Hamel blame for the children not learning their lessons? Hope you are noting it down. Who did M. Hamel blame for the children not learning their lesson? The first point is, their parents were not anxious enough to have the children learn. They preferred to put them to work on a farm or on the mills so that they can earn a little more money. And he blamed himself for sending the children to water his flowers instead of teaching them. And sometimes whenever he wanted to go for fishing, he gave them a holiday. And obviously, he blamed the children also because they did not have any interest in learning. These are the three points. Moving further. After this, M. Hamel, he started to talk about French language. Next question. What did M. Hamel say about French language? He said that this is the most beautiful language in the world, the clearest and the most logical language. And if they know the language, it is as if they have the key to their prison. When someone is imprisoned and if he has the key with them, they don't feel like as if they have been imprisoned. And knowing their language, it is as if they are having the key to their prison. After saying that, he opened his grammar book and started teaching. And that day, Franzi understood each and every word, everything taught by M. Hamel, as if he had never understood before. Everything seemed so easy and so clear. Actually, there are two points to it. One, the children or Franz, he was very attentive. And the second point is, Mr. M. Hamel, he was also very sincerely teaching them, as if he wanted to teach the children each and everything he knew before he left that place. And after the lesson in grammar, they had their lesson in writing. And that day, M. Hamel provided them all new copies. And they were asked to write two words, France and Alsace.